Huawei has just launched two of its new Mate handsets, the biggest smartphone offerings that Huawei has at the moment. And this is the Mate 10 Pro, a slightly updated version with a bit of a refined design as well and some boosted specs. Let's have a bit of a hands-on and see what we get. So first of all, as you can see, it's gone with a similar sort of design to the likes of the LG G6 with that display, 6 inches in size, mostly filling the front panel. Very tiny bezels above and below the screen and practically edge to edge. If we flip it over, it's got the usual aluminium frame, but this time it's covered in a glass backing. A little bit smudgy, as you can see under the lights here, but it comes in 4 different colors. So you can pick it up in mocha brown, pink gold, midnight blue, and titanium gray. The reason for the glass backing is more of an aesthetics thing than anything else. It doesn't support wireless charging, unlike the likes of the iPhone 8 and the iPhone 8 Plus, but definitely looks very snazzy, as long as obviously you carry a cleaning cloth with you. Well, the standard Mate 10 rocks a 5.9-inch LCD panel. The Pro version has a ever so slightly bigger 6-inch OLED panel, so you can expect nice sharp contrast levels, really deep blacks and the rest, and of course some nice punchy, vibrant colours as well. It's not quite as bright as the standard Mate 10, but as you can see there, on top brightness, it's absolutely fine. You'll have absolutely no problem seeing that, even in quite fierce glare. Good viewing angles and all the rest as well. It's 2160 by 1080 resolution, so it's not quite as sharp as some rivals like the Galaxy S8, the LG G6, but still perfectly crisp and not seeing any individual pixels on that one. And of course, it's a stretched 18:9 aspect ratio, so really well suited to the likes of movies and stuff like that. It's also a stereo speaker setup as well, just like on last year's Mate 9, so you get a speaker up top and also a speaker grill down below. As you'll see, there's no 3.5mm jack anywhere on the Mate 10 Pro. That's been ditched, although you will find it on the standard Mate 10, but you can get a Type-C adapter, so you can still use your wired phones if you want to. Otherwise, it's fully Bluetooth 5 compatible. In terms of performance, it's rocking Huawei's brand new, fresh and shiny Kirin 970 chipset, which is super, super powerful. It's now 20% more energy efficient than the 960, and the GPU has seriously taken a boost in terms of performance and efficiency as well. So you'll notice when you load up apps, they load up in an instant, and Huawei's got its usual AI shenanigans going on in the background as well, so it'll learn your favorite apps and make sure that they load up nice and quickly as soon as you tap them. And you'll find a 4,000 mAh battery packed inside the Mate 10 and the Mate 10 Pro, which supports Huawei's supercharged tech, which promises at least a half charge within about sort of half an hour or so. So it seems to be just on par with the likes of the P10 and the P10 Plus, and we're expecting the Mate 10 Pro to stay nice and cool as you're charging it up as well, despite that fast charge tech. And just like the standard Mate 10, there is a 4,000 mAh battery on board, which should give you about 2 days of battery life. And it also supports Huawei's supercharged tech, which means that it should power up in just over an hour. So I think they said it was 58% power within half an hour of charge. It should keep the phone nice and cool as it's doing it. And of course, you get the usual power saving mode, ultra power saving mode, and all the rest of it as well. Android Oreo version 8.0 is overlaid, of course, with Huawei's own Emotion UI, and this gets Emotion UI 8. It skipped ahead a bit from 5.1. Quite a few new features in there, most of them AI-focused. So you get the likes of a new floating dock indicator, which can replace the virtual on-screen buttons, so you can just swipe around wherever you want in order to go back home or load up the recent apps tray. Of course, you get all the usual features you would expect as well, the likes of one-handed control and the rest, which really helps out with the immense size of the Mate. And of course, if you dodge into the display more, you get the likes of eye comfort and all the rest of it as well. You can tweak the colors, the color temperatures and all the rest manually as well, if you require. This isn't final software, unfortunately, so we can't show off a lot of the Emotion UI 8 features, but we will definitely be doing a full hands-on with that when we get our hands on the final handset, which will be imminently. On the back of the Mate 10 Pro, you'll find another dual lens Leica camera, just like the Mate 9 and pretty much every other Huawei premium phone of the past few years. Once again, you get a 20 megapixel monochrome lens, as well as a 12 megapixel RGB lens, which is of course the main snapper. In this case, they've both got an f1.6 aperture, so they should be pretty good for low light shots. And you also get OIS built into that RGB lens as well, in order to keep your photos nice and sharp. As you can see, it's Huawei's standard camera UI, so you once again get lots of little filters and modes down this left-hand side. Just take a quick snap at the shutter button, you can swap to video mode at any time. And of course, you can flick through lots of different camera modes. You've got usual night shot to help keep the lens open a little bit wider, tuck in lots of light. Light painting mode, which again, holds the lens open for a long time to get some rather funky effects at night. Usual time lapse, slow-mo, 3D panoramas, all kinds of stuff to play around with. And of course, you get your full pro controls, which you can just pull out like so as well, to mess around with the likes of ISO levels, white balance, and the rest of it. Because of those f1.6 aperture lenses, the low light performance should be really strong. We will, of course, be testing them out in full. And you also get a new 4-in-1 hybrid focus, which is driven by that advanced dual image signal and processor, which combines laser depth, contrast, and phase detection focus in order to immediately zoom onto your subject, lock onto them, and keep them nice and sharp, no matter the conditions. And with full motion tracking as well, we're expecting good results. So that is, in a nutshell, the Huawei Mate 10 Pro. Check out our hands-on with the Huawei Mate 10 as well, and we'll be doing lots of comparisons and an in-depth hands-on with the EMUI 8 as well, so stay tuned for all that. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and give us a notifications bell ding. Cheers.